Okay, if you joined us for our previous video on Wall Drug in Wall, South Dakota, now join us for our trip through the Badlands of South Dakota. We are on, if you get off on exit 110 to visit Wall Drug, you just go straight across on Highway 296, I think it is. It's about, 8 miles down this road to the Badlands.
Right here, this is the Buffalo Jack National Grasslands.
Let's take a look. Mr. Dimples is a veteran, so he's got his lifetime pass, national park pass. We're all ready to go in. Won't cost us anything to drive through the Badlands, and we'll come out on I-90 about 40 miles down the road. Well, there's nobody in the station, so we can just proceed along. Okay, so since there was nobody at the station, there was a sign there that we can pay at the visitor center or show our card, our national parks pass. So we will do that at the visitor center. Let's check out the Badlands of South Dakota. Okay, just after passing the gates on the Wall Drug side or the south side of the Badlands, we can enter this little road here. I forgot what the name of this road is. It's a little washboardy. We usually do not take this road if we're on the motorcycles, but since we're in the Ram and Doc wants to go down here, he's going to get to see this. We got the Badlands to the left of us and Buffalo to the right. Look right here. Look right there. American bison. Live right beside the road. Do not get out of the truck. Badlands main road, if you're wondering. This is the one of the little offshoots that goes to the south unit of the Badlands, and you do not have to take this. We always take this because this is where the wild bison are. You've got a gorgeous view out to the side of you here. We just follow this road right on out here. There's also a campground out this way.
just joining us, we're the Transport Bandits, and we are traveling through the Badlands of South Dakota. Don't forget to subscribe and like. I'm suffering through this for you.
Bucket list ride. It's not that far. The loop road off of just right there. Get off of I-90. Take the loop road. Give yourself an extra hour drive time. It's worth it. Center. right across Badlands Scenic Loop. Over there. And we are right here right now at the visitor center. And then we will take this road right back out and get on I-9.
This book.
Oh no! Now the Badlands Loop Road, which is Highway 240, is a 27-mile meander through formations. You can access them from either entrance on I-90 at exit 131 at Cactus Flat, or from exit 110 at Wall. So you can get off I-90, do the 27 miles through the Badlands, and come back out on I-90, which is a good way to see the Badlands. If you're deadheading, I would not recommend bringing your camper or your tow haul through here. The roads are pretty rough. But if you're deadheading back to Indiana to pick up a load, yeah, why not? The Badlands was established as a national monument in 1939, and it became a national park in 1978. The Ben Rifle Visitor Center that we just showed you is open 362 days of the year. It'll be closed on New Year's, Thanksgiving, and Christmas. Now, we have been here on our bikes, and it can be very hot in the summertime. But right today, it is pretty chilly out. And there's not very many people in the park, so it's a great time to visit the park in the wintertime. Because it's just, you kind of got it all to yourself. You know, there's not any traffic. Wildlife are roaming around free. Like they aren't free in the summertime, but they're free where you can just stop and watch them for as long as you want without hindering any traffic behind you.
Unfortunately, we really haven't seen any wildlife other than the buffalo.
Yeah, a lot of times we'll see the doll sheep or bighorn sheep. Prairie dogs, and I'll show you some prairie dogs here in a moment. But take a look at this. This is an amazing place. Everybody should see this at least once. And if you can't get out here to see this, just enjoy it with our video. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Subscribe to our channel, and we'll show you more of America and great places you can visit. Hey, thanks for riding with us through the Badlands. We're going to exit out onto I-90 heading east towards Indiana now. And
we love the Badlands.
Absolutely. Badlands is definitely a must-see for any American.
I love riding my motorcycle through here.
It's a gorgeous place. Unusual landscape that is unlike anything else in the entire world. Just come here and see it.
So thanks for riding through with us. But I think in a few minutes, Cheryl's going to get out and show you some prairie dogs.
Prairie dogs! We love prairie dogs. Okay,
yeah, well, so Cheryl loves them.
We're going to a place called, oh, look here. Got some deer. Oh, sorry. Distracted.
But, Cheryl loves prairie dogs.
I do love prairie dogs.
I tolerate.
We're going to stop at the ranch store. It's on the way out on the north entrance or the east entrance of the Badlands. If you come in on the eastern exit, you'll hit that first. If you come on the western exit, you will hit that last. It's called the ranch store, and you can see the prairie dogs for free.
Well, they do have one.
They're
ranch.
Everywhere out here. We've got a lot of us. You know, they're like out there in the land.
They do have two prairie dogs at the ranch store. I like one of them is a giant prairie dog.
Yeah, let's see the giant prairie dog.
And it's so big it could be considered a monster. So yeah, I like that. And then they have the prairie dog on the motorcycle. And that's custom.
Yeah, that's we love the ranch store. So be sure to stop at the ranch store and check that out. Well, thanks for our ride along on the through the Badlands National Park. And we'll leave you with some footage of prairie dogs. And we'll be out on 90 headed back to This is the fun side of RV transport. When you don't have a camper on the back and you gotta head back, hit some of these cool places, see America. Or come see America with us. We'll we'll show it to you. Transport Bandits, Cheryl.
Don't forget to subscribe.
Transport Bandits out.
Out.
Okay, we're going to go into the ranch store. In the summer, this place is full of tourists. But we're going to see it without the people. Have it all to ourselves. There's the giant prairie dog.
It's monstrous.
Alright, there's the prairie dog on the motorcycle. We have many photographs of that. We have our bikes out here. You can buy prairie dog food on the inside and feed the prairie dogs. Now let's go see some prairie dogs. Here are the prairie dogs that I promised you. You can walk right in. You're welcome to. You just don't touch the prairie dogs. Oh, here comes one right now. I bet he's looking for some food. Sorry, dude. Hey, little guy. I'm not touching these little guys. They seem to be coming right up to me. Can you hear them bark?